Moving on to another big story that we are tracking on Mirror Now today. Heavy rains have lashed Bengaluru for over 2 days now, and IMD has predicted fresh spell of rains in parts of Bengaluru today as well. On Friday, the city came to a standstill after several parts of the city reported waterlogging. 300 houses were flooded and nearly 500 cars were washed away due to incessant rains. The most impacted was the southern part of the city, where several which actually received severe rains, and more than 50 millimeters of rain was actually recorded on Friday. So these are the visuals which we are showing from Bengaluru's different parts of Bengaluru actually got completely inundated because of incessant rains. And in fact, the figures which we are getting right now are that 300 houses have been washed away in these heavy rains, and several other vehicles, around 500 vehicles, were also washed away because of these rains. Remember, we have been showing these dramatic visuals from several parts of Karnataka. You can see how streets and roads are completely inundated with rainwater. Let's go across to Srija, who is live with us to give more updates. So Srija, what is the situation right now in the city?
Well, Gauri, in fact, just late last evening, we did see how torrential rains lashed the city of Bengaluru. Some of the areas that saw inundation was RR Nagar. Now, this is the area where we are standing. At least over 100 houses were completely, in fact, inundated. Now, to show also a panoramic view, you can see that quite a lot of houses in this particular area alone is in low-lying areas. And one of the reasons why we see every single year that we come back to the same place, also once again showing inundation. Now, another one, the most important reasons why inundation happens, especially in Bengaluru, is apart from the low pressure in Bay of Bengal, as far as IMD is concerned, we are also talking about the city alone, because what we understand is that several the storm water drains have not been desilted. Remember, during the lockdown time, the civic body had undertaken the work of desilting the storm water drains, but however, they had to stall it, which means that they were still waiting for at least about 500 crore rupee of funds. Now, since that particular fund did not come up, we understand most of the drains, which ran up to at least 400 kilometers, were not completely desilted. Now, that is one of the reasons why we understand why inundation has taken place. That apart, some of the areas that have reported inundation is like Hoskere Halli. Now, this is one of the areas where we saw the videos went completely viral. Several of the people were even recording videos to show how the cars, the vehicles were floating in the water. And that apart, Nagarbhavi, Kengeri area, Malleshwaram, Kormangala, just like every single year that we have reported, these are some of the worst affected areas as far as city of Bengaluru is concerned. Now, also sources working in the BBMP, they also claim that the construction of few new drains and remodeling of old drains have not been taken up. And as far as Karnataka State National Disaster Monitoring Center is concerned, they also tell us that they have identified close to 211 spots, especially these are the which are prone to flooding. So of course, another 2 to 3 days is going to be very crucial to understand, you know, as far as flooding is concerned, because this is a prediction that's not just coming in from Karnataka but also from IMD. Back to you.
Right. Thank you, Srija, for giving that update. Though it's not raining right now, and water levels have also receded in the city of Bengaluru, but the visuals that we are showing our viewers are extremely shocking. Goes on to show the kind of lapses and the kind of apathy that agencies are showing in Bengaluru, which actually is resulting in such severe water logging because of a few hours of rains.